I hope this finds you well. A wise man once said, if you think you are too small to make a difference, try sleeping with a mosquito. When mass incarceration or criminal justice reform are spoken of, the conversation usually includes the difficulty in correcting this flawed system. While no one denies that there are challenges, these challenges can be overcome with a small mental shift in our approach to mass incarceration. Consider where we would be if the 13th and 19th Amendments weren't proposed and ratified. Respectively, the abolishment of slavery and enfranchisement of women were both difficult hurdles in American history, but were overcome by the efforts of individuals coming together to create a whole. In this video, we are going to look at how you can get involved in and impact change to mass incarceration. I'm not going to rehash the astounding and appalling statistics here. If you want to see the numbers, take a look at my mass incarceration by the numbers video. Before we get into the suggestions, allow me a moment to discuss my opinions and some facts about mass incarceration. Mass incarceration is our own doing, and it is not only hurting the individuals and families within the criminal justice system, but also the good, law-abiding citizens and communities that have to further fund this flawed system of mass incarceration. Our drug laws, or war on drugs, is largely to blame for mass incarceration. The war was waged in the early 70s and has raged on ever since. Yes, we good-natured, God-fearing, tax-paying, and hard-working Americans are funding the incarceration of many drug users. Instead of sending them to college, we are sending them to criminal graduate school, where they oftentimes come out with a PhD in criminal activity and with even fewer means of supporting themselves. We, out of fear, distrust, and ignorance, have created a vicious cycle where drug laws ensure that many of our young men and women, predominantly low-income minorities, will never get off to a good start in life, if ever, because of an arrest on their record. Mandatory minimum sentences have stripped judges, the pinnacle of our criminal justice system, of the discretion to hand down sentences that match nonviolent crimes. Plea deals and the probation system ensure that individuals will continue to remain reliant on our tax dollars in some form or fashion, and almost guarantee that an individual will be arrested, jailed, or imprisoned more than once in their lifetime. This system will continue to eat away at our pocketbooks, affecting our good and bad citizens alike, until we say enough is enough. I, like you, can no longer stand by and say nothing. Thank you for bearing with me. Soapbox removed. Here is how you can be a part of correcting some of the flaws in the criminal justice system. Remember, these are only suggestions and practices of which I have tried myself. I can be a bit of a mad scientist. If you know of other good ways to help the cause, please share it with us all in the comments below. First, look at your attitude toward mass incarceration. Ask yourself the hard questions that only you know the answers to, and be honest with yourself. One attitude that must change is the stance that the poor and/or minorities commit more crime. All of us have felt this way before, and when we are honest with ourselves, we then can find a solution. If you tell someone they're a criminal long enough, they begin to believe it, and worse, they begin to become it. Know that police target low-income and minority communities, despite the fact that every single human being has broken some law in their lifetime. Right now, there are numerous individuals disobeying the speed limit, a law that is designed for the protection of everyone on the road. And while this may not be the same as drug use, it is a law nonetheless, and we don't think there should be a mandatory minimum for speeding. Arguably, speeding is more dangerous than drug use, and drug use usually only impacts the individual user and their family. Secondly, if you've been a subscriber for any length of time, you could probably guess that one of my suggestions would be to educate yourself. The mainstream media is not a good source of education. Books, statistics, and the investigation of government records are the best sources of education. Televised mainstream media is not very honest in many respects, but when it comes to mass incarceration and crime, they are particularly irresponsible. You have to do the digging for yourself. To get you started, understand that mass incarceration stems from that war on drugs. Mass incarceration is not the result of more violent crimes being committed. It is the result of disproportionate drug sentences and the criminalization of nonviolent crimes. Consider Brock Allen Turner, a 20-year-old who was found guilty of raping an unconscious 23-year-old female at a frat party. Brock was sentenced to 6 months in jail. Prior to the Fair Sentencing Act of 2010, signed by President Obama, 5 grams of crack cocaine triggered the 5-year mandatory sentence. It now takes 28 grams to trigger the 5-year mandatory sentence. The act only impacted the disparity between crack and powder cocaine. 1 gram of LSD or 5 grams of meth still gets you a mandatory 5 years in federal prison. A gram is comparable to a packet of sweetener. For shots and giggles, it takes 500 grams of powder cocaine and 100 grams of heroin to trigger that same 5-year sentence. If you're shocked, appalled, or your jaw is on the floor, it should be. Pick it up and let's continue. Third, join or volunteer with your state or national ACLU. The American Civil Liberties Union is freedom's watchdog. One of their core issues is mass incarceration. For nearly 100 years, the ACLU has defended individual rights in America, and oftentimes, some of those rights are unpopular. You can be popular, like many of our politicians who say what sounds good, or you can be right. Being tough on nonviolent crime isn't right. Being tough on violent crime is. Sending a drug user to jail or prison, who most likely is selling to support a habit or a family, does not correct the behavior. It makes it worse. And worse still, the low-level sellers or users are the ones that get ensnared in the system, while the high-level traffickers with the boats and planes continue to evade the justice system. Fourth, join the Sentencing Project. You can sign up at their website linked in the description below to stay up to date on initiatives, donate money, and/or be a part of local efforts to reform the criminal justice system. Civilrights.org is another good action site, also linked in the description. Finally, make your voice heard. You can do this in many ways. You can write your local legislators, attend city and town council meetings, request sit-downs with your local policy and decision makers to discuss mass incarceration, and speak about mass incarceration on social media. It is my sincere hope that you will have the courage to do something about mass incarceration. Our criminal justice system is not only destroying the lives of the few, but impacting us all in some form. As a taxpayer, here's what mass incarceration is costing you. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up, share it, and subscribe.